You hear my kid huffing and puffing in the background. Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. So another highly requested video. We are talking weight loss. How I lost weight, did I have surgery, what did I eat, what did I do? I'm gonna try to make it quick, short, and sweet. Y'all heard my knee crack? Yo, I'm getting old. Oh my god. Let me sit down. Oh, child. Okay.
At least I can jump over the couch.
Welcome back to my channel. So, I had a list of questions that people DM me and ask me, and I think I deleted it when I was cleaning out my phone because literally I almost had like 2 terabytes of full storage. But in today's video, we are going to be talking about weight loss. Because even though I have on like my everyday sweater, can y'all see my waist? I know you see the chiseled chin. My face used to be fat. Go watch one of them first videos I posted with my fat face. You see me now, baby? Okay. So, all the time in my DMs, ladies are like, oh my god, you look so good. What did you do? Sometimes I feel like they just must be new to my page. Because I feel like I talk about it a lot, but more so in my stories, so maybe they just miss it. But I did have weight loss surgery. I had gastric bypass last year, the end of July. I think it was like July 27th or July 20th, something like that. But I did have gastric bypass, RNY. It was one of the best decisions I've ever made in my life for myself. Weight loss surgery is definitely something that you do for you because that shit is hard. No lie. That shit is hard. Do not let anyone tell you that weight loss surgery is the easy way out because they've clearly have never had it. Take it from someone who's had it. Going to the gym and eating right and dieting, if that helps you lose weight, that is so much easier than having weight loss surgery. Because I've done both. I lost 65, 70 pounds in the gym, eating right, da 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 da. That was easy. My body didn't really go through a wild transformation. After surgery, you have to, the way you live completely changes. The way you eat changes, the way you drink changes, the way you move changes. Everything in your life literally changes, which is why before surgery, they make you do appointments for your mental. You have to get cleared by a fucking psych therapist. They make you do cardiac appointments to make sure your heart is strong enough to withstand the change that your body is going to go through. They make you go to a gastrologist to get an endoscopy to make sure your stomach like doesn't have any issues that you don't know about that's gonna stop you from being able to have the surgery. You have to go to nutrition appointments. I had to do 7 nutrition appointments where they teach you how you're gonna eat, how small you're gonna eat. They're gonna make sure that you really understand that you're not going to be able to eat the way you eat now. This shit was hard. I'm a year and change out and I still get sick multiple times a week. Literally. I was sick earlier. Because I ate a piece of ice cream cake last night, knowing I wasn't supposed to. And baby, you wanna talk about sick? I was sick. I was sick. Do my makeup, run into the bathroom because I was sick. So yes, this is not the easy way out. Don't let anybody tell you that. The second question I get a lot is how much weight did I lose in total? My weight fluctuated. Up and down. My highest, which is the reason why I decided to have surgery, because I've never seen this number on the scale. I think I didn't eat for like 3 days after I saw this. I saw 300 on this scale once and I was like, nah, no, ain't no way. It gotta be broke. Let me put it in the kitchen instead of the bathroom. Baby got back on that scale. That shit said it again. I said, oh no. Oh no. No, 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 no. I had gained 85 pounds in 1 year. 1 year. That's a lot of weight. 85 pounds is a lot of weight. I was so miserable. You know how miserable you gotta be to gain 85 pounds in 1 year? I was miserable. Couldn't hide it. So I just ate. You know what it is? It's not even that I ate. I drink. I drink a lot. And liquor is all empty calories. I drank a lot. And it showed. I went out a lot. I didn't want to be in the house. I didn't want to be around the person I was living with. I hated everything going on. So I would take my daughter out to eat every day. Me and my friends would go out to eat every day. I was going out for drinks 3-4 times a week. Like, we were always out. And it caught up to me bad. So then I decided, all right, I'm going to make this change. I'm going to do this. Started the process. And it was awesome. I had state insurance at the time. So it was fully covered by my insurance. I only had to come out of pocket for was some of the doctor visits had co-pays. And then the medication after surgery. I had to pay, not full, but some of it, whatever the like minimum is that you pay for the medications. I had to pay for that. Other than that, almost everything was covered 100%. I went through the steps already, all the different doctor's appointments and nutrition appointments. You can only do one nutrition appointment a month. So whatever your surgery is, if they tell you you need 3 nutrition appointments, then you probably get it done in like 3-4 months and then you get to have surgery. I was scheduled, it's funny that this happened because it just happened with my tummy tuck. I was scheduled to have my surgery in March, and then everyone thought we were only going to be quarantined for like 2 weeks for COVID, and then it turned into like 2 years. So the numbers had got so high in the hospital again that they ended up pushing my surgery all the way back to the end of July. So I did that, had surgery. The surgery itself was easy. You know, you don't remember it. You're asleep. The only thing post-surgery, initially that was hard, was the gas pain after. You know, you got to walk it off. They blow your stomach up with all that air. So then when you get out of surgery, you're literally full of gas. Walking that off helps. But, you know, it's painful. I probably was on my couch for like 2 days. That was it. Because I had just got the store around that time. And I couldn't sit. I didn't have the luxury of sitting still. So I gave myself like 2 days and then I jumped back into like life. Like, I got a kid, so I didn't really have the luxury of just laying up for a week. I think they tell you that you should not work for like a week or 2 weeks, something like that. So yeah, then you do that. You're on a liquid diet for 2 weeks. Some surgeons have you do a liquid diet 2 weeks before surgery and then 2 weeks after surgery. My surgeon had me on a liquid diet 7 days before my surgery, and baby, I cheated every day. Besides the day before surgery, I ate one meal a day. There was no way my stomach before surgery was gonna be satisfied. It's really straight discipline. With just liquid, like, how much chicken broth and Gatorade Zero am I supposed to drink? Don't follow me. Because I and some people in my surgery group, and I'll tag the surgery group below, it's called Black Girls Have VSG2. They got me through this because none of my friends ever had this surgery. So I would ask all my questions. I made friends in there. I'll tag the girls that I met in there. I'll tag their Instagrams down here because I've met some amazing people in the group who answer questions and give advice and give help. But yo, not gonna lie, the week before surgery really tests your gangster light. Because I still gotta feed my kid every day. So now I gotta cook dinner, buy dinner for her, and I'm just looking at it and I can't even eat. Like, this is crazy. So I would like nibble here and there. I do remember I got Taco Bell. So I was like, yo, I need one last hoorah meal before I give my life the skinny god. And baby, I had Taco Bell. You know what it's like for your body to process Taco Bell on E? Word to my mother, I did not cheat after that. Not one meal. Not one. I was so scared. I was on the toilet like I had just drank a bottle of Dubra Street. That's how bad it was. Never again. I won't even really eat Taco Bell to this day. That's how bad that shit was. Literally. Like the painful, like, oh, I'm old. On the toilet like that, hunched over. Nope, not worth it. But then, you know, eventually you move on to your soft foods. You get like your routine going. I still to this day drink protein shakes. My eating habits right now are non-existent, if that makes sense. I can't really eat like shit because I don't really eat. I'm having trouble with like having an appetite, and just getting in the proper amount of protein. I live off of Gene Pro. I'll put a picture right here. It's a little expensive, but one serving is 30 grams of protein. If you watch my vitamin video, I take that liquid protein. They save my life because I really don't ever really have an appetite for real. Like, if we're being completely honest, I will pick when I cook for the kids at the food. And then after I serve them and my boyfriend eats, I'll eat whatever's left over in his plate. Or I'll bite his food. Like, I'll bite a piece of his chicken before I give it to him. Or I'll bite a piece of chicken and put it back in the regular bowl. And then someone will eat it later. But that's really, like, how I eat. Like, I try. I'm going to work on. That's one of the things I'm going to work on this year. I'm going to work on getting more real, solid protein and food in. Because it's major. When I wasn't eating at all, like before I was taking the protein, I was losing my hair. My skin looked trash. Like, everything was just terrible. So protein plays a major part in keeping yourself together, keeping your stomach together. I also went through a phase where all I wanted to do was drink shakes and protein. That was trash for me too, because my stomach got so small that every time I ate solid food, which still happens to this day, I would get nauseous and then I would get a stomachache because my body is not used to processing solid food. It only wanted protein shakes and like smoothies. Terrible. Terrible thing to do to myself. Never do it again. So I'm trying to recover from that right now. Another question I get a lot is, what was like my family and friends outtake on having surgery? They didn't really care. My mom was more nervous about like me physically going into surgery and not coming out. That was like her big thing. I wasn't really worried about that. My dad was really excited for me. My dad is one of my best friends. My dad was really excited for me because his mom was overweight and he saw the effect that it had on her life. So he was excited that I was excited and making a change in my lifestyle and whatnot. All my friends were supportive. They couldn't wait till I could start drinking. Yo, the first night out after surgery, I didn't drink for like four months. Even now, I get lit off of a half a glass of wine. Three sips in and I'm like, whew. And I can't take shots. Don't pass me no shots. I can't take shots. I'm gonna go right to the bathroom and throw up. Do not pass me a shot. Nope. Nope. Please don't. If you ever seen like my TikToks or like follow me on Instagram at TheRealAnnaJ and you see me out with like Tiff and someone gives us some shots or buys us some shots, you're gonna see me take it. I'm either gonna fake it or I'm gonna pour it in my drink and then sip it. I'm not taking no shot. Don't even pass it to me. Because I'm going to either give it to somebody else and be like, every time I see Kenya, take this. Swear to God. I don't even play like that. I'm not even gonna set myself up. Speaking of the devil, look at Kenya texting me. Yo, Kenya just bought mad candles. I hope one of these are for me. You like to say hi because you are just come on, come in the camera, say hi.
Hi,
come on, hurry up. 1, 2, 3, jump. Oh, oh my god. Okay, say hi and then disappear. Say hi.
Hi.
All right.
Hi.
Ask me if I physically feel better. Yes, even though I'm sick a lot, physically, like walking, exercising, being in the gym, and not like about to pass out on the elliptical. The Stairmaster still sucks. I don't care how thin I am, the Stairmaster still sucks. Physically, I do feel better. Definitely. Definitely. Someone asked me about my love life. My boyfriend don't give a shit. He don't care how I look for real. As long as I'm happy and I'm out here looking all crazy, he don't care. I swear to God, he don't care. That man just, he loved me for me. That's it. We were best friends before anything. So he knew me. He knew me before surgery. So yeah. I was never worried about that. What else? Want plastics. I know you guys see it. Definitely. I'm getting nipped and the fuck tucked. I'm getting my tummy tuck. I'm getting a complete mommy makeover. So legs, arms, boobs, ass, everything. Everything's getting done up. Done up. It's gonna take me a little while because it's expensive, but everything is getting done up. Know that. Can't wait. I think that's like the most exciting part for me, is to really see, like, I'll put a before and after picture here. Yep, clap, because I did that. Okay, so let's backtrack real quick before I finish talking about plastic surgery. The comments when I post my weight loss pictures on Instagram. This is what I say when I say don't let people downplay your surgery. They be like, oh, you had surgery, that's why you lost weight. My nigga, I know people who had surgery who gained all their weight back. They ate what they wanted to eat and still got fat right after. They thugged it out. They was sick. They shit. They throw up, whatever. They gained all their weight back and stretched their stomach out. It happens. The revision weight, the revision rate for surgery is astronomically high, for real. The succeeding rate is not that high. They expect you to mess up. I'm not lying. Like, I still have to go meet with my surgeon and do doctor's appointments. They want me on their billboard. I don't know if it's my face. I mean, I know it's because I lost 130 pounds, but, and you know, you see this face, like, this isn't a face that, like,
a billboard
comes around every day. You know how good I'm gonna look when y'all drive it down 95 and it's gonna be one of them billboards that say the old me, the new me, and I'll be pointing at my old self. Oh no, it'll be like a shadow and you standing in front of your fat self, like your skinny self standing in front of your fat self. Yeah, I'm gonna be on one of those. Watch,
a billboard.
Shh. What else? There's that. Someone asked me, what were one of your favorite memories post-surgery about losing weight? Word to my kid. Me and Camille go a lot of places. We do stuff. That's what we do. We do things. We went to, what was it, Lake Compound, Six Flags? We went somewhere this summer. And you put that thing on. Like, when you're on the roller coaster. Cam loves roller coaster. She's not scared of nothing. You put that thing on. When you get on the roller coaster, yo, when I was big, you know, it don't go down all the way. So you got, like, space. You be scared, like, damn, am I going to fall off the ride? Like, it's not clicking how everybody else's is clicking. Word to me, I put that thing on and went all the way down. I was like, oh, this is what it's supposed to feel like? I'm not going anywhere. That was one of my favorite, like, oh, moments. Another one is I had saw somebody who did not like me. We were in the club. She didn't like me. Gia called me all types of fat on Facebook. Sis saw me in the club and was like, girl, you look good. Gave me a hug, everything. She was like, I know our beef was stupid. Yes. I know. Tell me again. I look good. Thank you. That was another one. Let's see. My first ever one, I was jean shopping. I don't really wear jeans like that, you know, because when you're losing weight, and that's a mistake. Don't make this mistake. This is a mistake I made. I was buying too many clothes, and then I kept having to keep buying clothes because I keep losing weight. So I was going jean shopping, and I had went to the Gap and bought like 8 pairs of jeans. And I was like, I didn't think I was going to get any smaller than a 12, no, than a 14, right? Because I had never been smaller. Like, my first memory, I think I was like a size, the smallest I ever remember being was like a 14, 16. So, and that was like high school. So I had got down to a 14 and I was like, yeah, I'm not getting no smaller than this. Like, that's gonna look crazy. Like, so I bought like 8 pairs of jeans from the Gap. I spent some money. I put one of them jeans on one day and they were too big. I was like, what? What? I think I was more mad at the fact that I had to go buy more jeans. But I was happy. So then I go to American Eagle. And I try on an American Eagle 14 and it was still too big because I needed a black pair. We was going to Sassoni Mambo, needed a black pair of jeans. Those were too big. So then I'm like, nah, not 12. I ain't never been a 12. Never, not a 12. I put that 12 on, that 12 had room. I wouldn't even buy the 10. The 10 fit, it was a little tight, but the 10 fit, I wouldn't buy the 10. I was too scared. Why I'm a size 10 now? I don't have not one pair of jeans that fit me. They're all too big. And I refuse to buy jeans until after my tummy tuck. I'm not buying jeans after my tummy tuck. It's not happening, Captain. I buy outfits as I go out. If I need something to wear, I'm going to order it. I'm going to run to the mall, try to find something quick in one of the baby girl stores in like Windsor. You know, my camera be dying. Cannon batteries. But yeah, I run in. I shop as I go now. I don't shop just to shop. You probably see me in vlogs. This is my favorite sweatshirt. I wash it like 3 times a week. I always have this sweatshirt on and like a pair of leggings and my Ugg slides. That's like my go-to outfit. A sweatshirt or a long sleeve shirt with some leggings. That's it. Oh, 99% of the time, I look bummy. But when I step out, you know, I be looking like, and yeah. Know me. But I think that's it. If you have any more questions, I can always do a part 2 to this video, or if you comment any questions below and it's something I could answer quick, I'll just literally just answer in the comments. If you're looking forward to having weight loss, or if you're questioning it, or if you're thinking about it and don't know who, this is your sign to do it. Do it. Do it. This is your sign to do it. Do it. I promise you, you'll love it. I promise you, whether it's the sleeve, whether it's gastric, just do it. It will literally change your life. Do it. And then tell me that you did it, or tell me that you're doing it. So I can like follow you and we can be friends. And I can answer like, you know, any questions you have. If you have any other videos that you want me to make, please comment or DM me. I have a lot of time right now. So yeah, that's it. Thank you once again for tuning into my channel. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Camille, tell them again.
And comment down below.
And comment down below. You heard the kid. But until my next video, I will see you guys. Toodaloo. Y'all see these beautiful roses my boyfriend bought me? Like, aren't they just so pretty? They look so good next to me.
So those are pink instead of red. Thanks.